recycling manager? That's crazy.
Alright, let me just check the audio on the stream. I'm gonna turn it on for you.
A long time ago, on a very peculiar day, my mirror lured someone out of his bed and opened a doorway to my workshop.
It's a tower defense game. That's boring.
I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious.
Alright, let me hear this.
Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project. I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten.
After this opening cutscene, I might turn down the audio. Just so I can hear you better.
Oh shit, you're alive. Look at that.
Satisfied with
you're
my
alive.
Progress.
I'm alive!
I put the magic brush down.
You're alive!
And
I'm alive!
What's up, nerds?
He's alive, Tarzan!
Not Clayton.
Had I known
Clayton,
what
you remember that one world, picture of Clayton as the Joker we can't get out of our head?
Yeah, my favorite is always gonna be freaking Willem Dafoe as the Joker.
Oh yeah. Where he has like the paint running down his face.
Mm-hmm. It just makes sense, dude. It just makes sense.
In the original, did it sound like this too? Like, did the music sound like an orchestra?
I kind of have the original turned off because I don't want to hear double voices.
Yeah, no problem. Wait, are you watching me through Twitch or the stream?
Now it'll be Twitch.
Like, are you watching me through Discord or Twitch?
Oh shit, you're streaming on Discord too.
Yeah.
To see what
it sounds
happened.
Like the original,
but I was too late.
Oh, because I never played the original.
I had created was ravaged.
So I don't know if this is like a new soundtrack, like a redone
gone.
Orchestrated soundtrack.
I did not learn his identity.
I would assume so.
Well,
yeah.
It sounds like it.
It's the asshole that let Aqua in the realm of darkness in Kingdom Hearts. Freaking Mickey Mouse and terrorists.
Kingdom Hearts is on Steam, right?
Yeah.
Hey,
they're like atrocious price.
Yeah, I saw they're like $50.
Yeah.
Same with Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy VII is like almost $100. Oh shit! Oh shit.
Yeah, this game is dark, dude. I guess it's like real existential dread, bro. Here's a little context for this game.
Alright, let me just put the audio. I think that sounds good.
Epic Mickey 1 originally came out in...
Let me just check on the my monitor here.
Mickey... came out in 2010. I think it was a Wii exclusive.
Let me just set my model here.
Well, it's...
So yeah, Wii exclusive.
It came out in November of 2010, but in North America and the PAL territories, it came out August 2011 in Japan. Yeah, 2010 North American PAL territories, and in August in Japan the following year.
The sequel?
The first game.
So this one we're playing?
So originally it was developed by Disney Interactive.
Yeah, I think it was Activision game, right?
Activision, I think they published it.
Or were they the distributors?
Okay, so the publishers were Disney Interactive, but the developers were Junction Point Studios. The Rebrushed version, the one you're playing right now, was developed by Purple Lamp. Yeah, Purple Lamp.
Yeah, they're the ones that did the SpongeBob remake.
Yeah. And THQ re-released this, so they were the publishers this time around.
Alright, everything's good. So we can start a new game.
Yeah, so it originally came out on the Wii, which is kind of weird. But, you know, it's the Wii. It had cool games.
Mm-hmm. Who's that?
Who's what?
The old man.
Yen Sid?
Is that really his name?
Is it the wizard dude?
I don't... Look at the screen!
Oh, I forgot his name. He was in, like, the original...
Oh, is it, like, this, like, that old Mickey Mouse short where he's, like, getting tortured?
I think so,
With the buzzsaw?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what this is?
It's Mad Scientist. I forgot his name, dude.
Cortex?
I'll check soon.
He kind of looks like Cortex. Cortex, if he wasn't yellow. If he didn't look like a Simpson. Is he trying to steal his heart?
His kingdom heart?
Why does this look like... I don't even want to make that joke.
What?
I was gonna say, why does this look like some kinky stuff?
Nah, dude, he's doing CIA experiments. By the way, my joke is way darker than yours, so I think I win that contest.
Look, it's Oogie Boogie.
Oh no. Scary black shadowy thing.
Okay, don't be racist.
I wasn't. You're the one who went there.
You said scary black thing.
I said scary black shadowy thing. There's a difference. I'm not freaking Shadow the Hedgehog.
Oh yeah, disgusting black creatures. Dude, you wanna know what makes that...
I swear that...
You know what makes that cutscene even funnier? Is that Sonic is in the background giving a thumbs up.
I never noticed it. Can we have that in the movies?
Sonic giving a thumbs up every time Shadow says something racist.
Yeah. So, yeah. Power of Illusion.
Alright. Now we're playing. Oh.
So, Power Illusion that came out on the DS is supposed to be a companion game.
Okay.
Which is kind of like you're supposed to play them at the same time, sort of. Power 2.
Am I going the right way? Oh, I'm supposed to follow this guy.
Oh, I wonder if this new version has co-op.
Has who?
Has multiplayer for 2.
Maybe.
Because I think the original one had it, yeah? No, the original one did not have multiplayer. That was only the second one. Oh, dude. You want to know something about this game that's pretty cool?
What?
It has a morale system.
What's that mean?
Basically, it has a morality system. If you do something bad or good type thing. It's similar to Infamous or Spider-Man Webs of Shadows and Shadow the freaking Hedgehog, dude. Different alliances, side quests, and power-ups are made available depending on the choices the player makes.
Oh!
It is also possible to avoid mini-bosses if specific actions are taken. The endgame currency e-tickets are important to these boss fights. Oh, that's gonna be interesting. I hope they kept it. Oh, they also developed Epic Mickey.
Da na na. Received a new item, Bronze Pin.
So, you know the Junction Point, the developers of this game?
Mm-hmm.
They have 2 canceled games. An untitled Half-Life 2 episode. Ooh. Which is quite interesting because I did not know about that.
For what, this?
Oh, the developers of the original release of the game. And Sleeping Giants, whatever that is.
And you said this is a Wii exclusive?
It was originally a Wii exclusive, yeah.
I thought this was a multi-platform game.
Maybe, but that's what the wiki is saying, so... There's also the Castle of Illusion.
Oh god!
But that's like a Genesis.
Oh god.
Yeah, Genesis game, I think. Man, oh man, Epic Mickey platforms. true this is. And I hope it is, because that would mean they don't have to remake the second one. And I can't remember who said this to me, but apparently
Oh, I like this animation.
Apparently the remake includes the second game.
This reminds me of that Mickey Mouse show that was on, like, the Disney Channel in... What year was it? 2017?
Dude, is that the one where he's like, what happened?
I can't remember.
I'm gonna send you a gif.
All I remember is that it was like in like 7 minute shorts. You know what else it reminds me? It reminds me of Inside Out when like they go inside the tunnel. And like it changes the art style.
Wow, is this a Metal Gear game?
Metal Gear? Epic Metal Gear.
Solid Mickey?
Solid Mickey. Yeah, it is that animated one.
That Snake.
What is that reticule on my screen? Do you see that?
The sound of my brush. It keeps alerting the guards. Yeah, if you ever get the chance, definitely play Kingdom Hearts on
stream.
As I have a shit ton of things to talk about on that, honestly.
Oh, look, now we're playing Splatoon.
See? Epic Mickey did it before it was cool.
Your brush can also thin out objects like that door frame.
Oh boy! Time to commit war crimes!
Mickey said quietly. Is this a prison break, right?
I don't know.
Breaking out of prison.
Oh, why wasn't I doing this?
I have 60 minutes before I have to go get the laundry, so...
And we're only 18 minutes in.
Yeah. Dude, spray him with your goo.
My goo!
Your Nickelodeon goo.
Why does he run out of goo every time he jumps?
Oh yeah, you wanted me to find out who that old dude was?
What old dude? Oh, the guy from the game.
I assume his name is...
But it was that same guy from the short, right?
Yeah, he's from a short. I think it's the same dude.
Oh, you know what that looks like? That looks like the Globs of Doom from the Nickelodeon game. Do you remember Do you remember the Nicktoons games?
Ooh, Nicktoons was cool, dude.
That's what it kind of looks like the villains from the Nicktoons games.
Yeah, he's the Mad Doctor from the Mad Doctor short. Mickey hat. Walt Disney's Mickey's hat.
You know what it also looks like?
What?
It looks like Mike Wazowski.
Mike Wazowski.
Dude, it's always Mike Wazowski, but what if you don't? What if it is Mike without ski?
Like the original Mike Wazowski where he had no arms?
Yeah. I love that meme. The Mike Wazowski one?
Which
Mike
one?
Without skis?
Where he has the Solis face or whatever?
Yeah, it's so dumb.
Mike Wazowski, whatever it's called?
Oh, dude, I don't know if you saw this. You might have. But Tomb Raider 4, 5, and 6 are getting a remaster collection.
Look, it's a gremlin. It's the gremlin from the movie Gremlins.
It's a gremlin.
Wait, was that Disney too?
What, Gremlin?
Yeah.
I don't think so, but then again, by now, it's probably owned by them.
Wait, how do I kill these guys?
So the remastered collection for the Tomb Raider 4 through 6.
Oh, there you go.
Is coming out next year, February 24th. Which I believe is Lara Croft's birthday. Dude, one of these days, we gotta play one of the games I have. Like a game you have no idea what you're doing in.
Like Noita?
What?
Like Noita?
I don't know what that is, dude.
It's a game on Steam.
First time I'm hearing about it.
Are you sure? It's a really popular game.
I tend to not pay attention to like some popular games.
You don't care about Stardew Valley?
I like Stardew Valley. There's just some of the genres I tend to not go towards.
Like what?
But I still check them out every now and then.
Like what?
You never know, right? I'm not very big on tower defense games, but you know, sometimes I like to play them. It's a lucky emblem. Sora, take a picture, Sora.
It's the hidden Mickey.
Sora.
Did you know that, what was it? Like the Mickey Mouse Capade game that if you take it apart, it has a thing in the cartridge that's like, in the shape of Mickey Mouse's head?
Oh, that's kind of cool, dude. Wishes you mad scientist, yeah.
Could you imagine if that was like, dude? Can you imagine if like that was the case for everything? Like let's say the Switch port of this game. Like you take it apart and then like inside the Switch cartridge,
is a gun.
No. It's the hidden Mickey head.
That Mickey head is a gun.
Wait, can I take fall damage?
I'm kidding.
Yep, you can.
Imagine if you just, like,
killed him?
Died right there.
Like, I had one health left?
It's like Dark Souls, man.
Yeah, at least the fall damage isn't too punishing.
Dark Souls? Okay, so there's this area in Dark Souls. I think it's the area past the Fair Lady.
Mm-hmm.
Not the Fair Lady. What's her name? It's past the Quela boss fight. And you could technically do a well-timed speedrun glitch.
Mm-hmm.
You jump off a cliff, but you still take a massive chunk of damage. But it's still better than the fall damage in 2, I think. No, 2's fall damage wasn't too bad. It was mainly 1. I don't know, it's been a while since I played those games. I mostly play. What have I been playing lately? Elder Scrolls games? Especially Oblivion and 5. But, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why all of
the choices you're gonna make.
I honestly don't know why all of a sudden I got hooked on DreamWorks Racing.
Hey, dude.
Would you play that?
What choices? What?
DreamWorks Racing, the one that I showed you.
Oh, I haven't yet.
But would you?
Maybe. If I could get more people to play it. Oh, since you're checking out,
oh god.
Racing games, you should check out this Disney game called, like, Split/Second. Is it a Disney game?
Oh, Speedstorm?
No, it's another racing game they did before that.
Ooh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's called Split Second Velocity.
Hmm.
This was when they were still doing, yeah, this was in the 2010-2011 era. It's on Steam, it's usually cheap. It goes on sale fairly quick.
What goes on sale?
Split Second. The Disney game, whatever. I think they only did the publishing. I'm trying to pay attention to my alarm because I do not want you to get a copyright strike.
Why would I get striked?
You never know, dude. You never know.
Why, what is it?
It's a Limp Bizkit song.
Oh.
It's not a video game music, so it's... Then again, Fred Durst and that crew are pretty cool people, so they're pretty chill. At least they look like they're chill. I don't know. I I don't know who the shit Gus is, though. Is this an original character?
Maybe it's someone who they locked up in the Disney vault.
You mean the Disney dungeon?
pretty much. It's like Area 51, but for Disney.
I'm still waiting for my boy Cody to...
Oh! There's a thing up there!
Corey. Still waiting for my boy Corey in the house to release on Disney Plus.
Did you see that meme that's going around of Corey in the house?
Nah.
It's of him, like, chasing the little boy with the skeleton on the wheelchair.
What the shit?
Just look up Corey in the house. Corey got a bone hand.
Bone hand.
It's him like scaring the shit out of a kid with the, and he puts like a skeleton on a wheelchair.
That's. Yeah, you hit it. Extra content unlocked. Towers. Ooh. Hmm. We already passed the hour and the end date, so I'm not gonna make jokes. If you know, you know.
Here's what I was supposed to do. Oh god. Pull the lever.
There you go. I'm gonna send it to you though, so.
Oh god. Cool. Is it gonna show something that I might get striked for?
Probably. I don't know.
Guys, if I get striked, it's your fault. No, I'm just kidding.
If you get strike, it's my fault, dude. I don't know, Disney's weird sometimes.
Alright, let's just... Okay, let's see what this... Oh no, it's...
These were real shorts when they came out. Mickey and the Beanstalk.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that like I hope it doesn't actually play. Oh, now we're playing Mario 64.
And now it's a platformer.
Yeah, now it's 2D.
2D one. It's real cool. So this is kind of like how the Tower of Illusion looks like.
Disney Infinity had a callback to these levels. Do you remember the Disney Infinity, like, the Inside Out levels?
Is they even
released
an Inside Out level?
Yeah, I was playing it on a stream when Inside Out 2 came out.
Didn't, like, Infinity 3 came out, like, in...
It came out 2014? In 2014, but they were still doing content up until 2016. Because 2017, I believe, was going to be the release for the fourth one.
And then that got canceled. Which I'm still upset about.
Yeah, because I actually genuinely enjoyed that series.
No, I've never played them. I just heard about the...
I thought you did play them.
No, I saw a video talking about, like, the Disney Infinity series and the canceled ideas for 4. the cancel ideas for the fourth game, and it was just cool, man.
Mm-hmm.
Which is some cool shit. Hashtag give us Infinity 4.
Like, make a Kickstarter.
Yeah. I'll Kickstarter myself on Patreon. I'll fund the whole project if I have to. Crackdown.
Oh, what is this? Full of beans. Complete the first side-scrolling level. Would you like to travel to Salam? Yes. Salam and good evening.
Arabian? Oh wait, I can't sing that on stream.
You can. If you just sing like one part, I don't think they'll get mad.
Big D is gonna be mad.
Big D?
And I'm honestly hoping they go bankrupt, so...
They're on the verge of going bankrupt.
So I'm not gonna give them an excuse to sue me. Actually, isn't, like, Ubisoft on the verge of bankruptcy?
I don't know.
Or, like, they're hoping to be bought out recently? I don't know. But Disney is, like, it's like a 50-50 chance. 60-50 to be... No, 60-40 to be fair. Because they still release good things, but it's like very rare for them to do it now.
Yeah, I thought Inside Out 2 was good. Oh, by the way, did you watch The Wild Robot yet?
Nah, not yet.
You should. It's a really good movie.
Oh, did you see that, that trailer from, I don't know why, 10 British for a second.
What trailer?
It's the new Laika movie.
Lion King?
Laika Studios.
Oh, which one? You mean the Lego movie?
No, Laika Studios, dude. The people behind Coraline and all those good movies.
What are they doing?
They're releasing a movie called The Wiles.
The Wiles?
Let me double check. Is it The Wild?
The Wild is a Disney movie. Isn't it?
They made Paranorman, Kubo, and...
I still need to watch Paranorman. I also need to watch Box Trolls, Frank and Weenie, all those stuff.
Wildwood, that was the name of the movie coming out next year. It's an adventure horror movie, so I'm gonna check it out. Hmm. It's based on a 2011 novel of the same name.
Did you want to watch the Inside Out 2 in the server one day? Or did you already watch it?
I haven't watched it yet.
Oh god.
I do keep seeing memes about it. So, my favorite meme is the horny emotion meme.
Oh yeah! It's like, Riley, get your fingers out of there. Is that the one you're talking about?
Yeah, and then there's the buff meme. Or whatever it's called.
The buff meme?
Maybe it's just the same meme, but it's the dude's just buff. I'll show you the image later. The meme.
Who's that?
So who are these, like,
David, who's that? Movies? Who's that?
I don't know, dude. Don't ask me. Do I look like the...
Yes.
Developer? It's the Shadow Monsters. I don't know.
The Shadow Man?
The Shadow Man.
He comes
out.
Yeah, he comes out and he says, "Are you ready?"
You do want to be rich, don't you? You know what I'm talking about, Lawrence.
Is that his name?
No, the fat dude was Lawrence. The chubby dude, I mean.
Yeah, that was her father, right?
No, the dude who's working, who works for Naveen, for a bit.
No, but wasn't there also Charlotte's father?
Yeah, Charlotte's father was also Big Daddy.
Big Daddy?
Yeah, that's what he's called.
Dumbo!
Big Daddy. Oh, Big Daddy! I can't do it.
Wait, is this supposed to be a reference to Abandoned by Disney?
Yeah. Disney.
Because there's like a theme park here now.
Sick, dude.
The Guardians? We get to play with the Guardians?
The Guardians of the...
Your favorite... Guardians? Yeah, isn't that your favorite DreamWorks movie?
Such a good movie.
Would you play as Jack Frost? Dude, would you play as Jack Frost if they put him into DreamWorks Racing?
Heck yeah. Yo, remember back in the day where people were just making fan fiction of, and like fan images of Elsa and Jack?
No, but I remember watching one as a kid where it was like, the Sandman and Pitch Black, they gave birth to Mavis and Rapunzel, and they
the most cursed sentence I've heard.
And then they ended up being like lesbian for each other.
And I've seen freaking DeviantArt, so.
Oh, you know what I'm talking about then.
Shut the fuck up, dude! I don't want to talk about this no more. That is such a cursed image. Pitch Black and Sandman.
No, but they're like two like separated people. Like, it's kind of like a two worlds, one family kind of deal.
Yeah, I know, dude. I know what you're talking about, but still, like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I didn't make it. I just found it. I just stumbled upon it when I was like 9 years old.
9 year old me looking through the web at 3 a.m. in the morning.
Dude, look at this. Can I go on to rides?
Maybe.
You can! Oh, this is a great game now.
Go get those tickets, dude.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know what you can purchase with this.
The tickets?
Because this is also... Yeah.
Maybe it's just
They're also tied to your boss fights.
Maybe it's to, like, unlock, like, gates or something, like Banjo or something.
Ooh. What if they're to unlock optional boss fights?
Optional boss fights? Up there, you piece of shit. Get up there, you freaking dickhead.
Dude, don't say shit. Mickey's gonna send the secret police after you.
What police?
I joke, but like... I don't know.
The horny police?
Yes. Maybe.
I do like controlling Mickey Mouse in this. Gotta say.
Why does he say, oh boy, every time he jumps?
Because every time he jumps,
he gets this feeling. Oh, yeah. So, in the second game, you could play as Oswald and Mickey.
Oh, look, there's a little teacup ride.
On the little teacup.
Can I make a rocket ship out of it? Rocket ship?
Hey, dude, you know, it'd be pretty cool. Kick Butkowski.
Kick Butkowski?
Yeah.
But that was a Canadian show, wasn't it?
That was a Disney XD show.
You mean the program where, like, Disney slowly starts to kill off their cartoons? Because that was at the time when, I don't remember if I talked about this on stream or not, but I remember seeing, they were saying that, like, there was a point in time where Disney was only doing sitcoms and they were putting all the cartoons to Disney XD.
Oh yeah, I remember that. It was such a weird time, too. There were some cool shows.
Like Gravity Falls.
Well, Gravity Falls is sort of getting a sequel.
Oh, did I tell you that I finally bought the book of Bill Cipher?
Yeah, that's the sequel I was talking about. How was Bill the book? How was the Bill book?
I actually haven't got into it yet, because, like, I've been working my bum off so much.
You nerd. Read that shit, nerd. I've seen a few reviews of it. Analysis videos. Freaking word, I cannot speak right now. It's pretty late.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I thought I could get up there.
There's a few characters I still want to see in Kingdom Hearts. And they only show up as summons.
Oh, like, summons like in Final Fantasy?
Yeah. They work a bit different, but essentially they're Final Fantasy summons.
Hmm. Final Fantasy VII's are like monsters, right?
I don't remember what are the summons for VII. But if it is anything like the past games, it would probably be Shiva, Ifri, and Bahamut.
Oh god.
Behemoth, whatever it's called.
No, not that. It was just like the game was acting kind of laggy.
And there's a few summons that don't reappear in Final Fantasy, and some of them I really want.
I like that effect that every time Mickey Mouse jumps, like, there's like paint that sprays everywhere.
That's not paint. That's the blood of his victims.
Oh, I was gonna say, David, be careful with what you say. Don't get me demonetized.
That's the blood of his targets.
It's the blood of his victims.
Which, I don't know how it's worse than what I was originally gonna say.
Oh god. It's a froggy.
Why does the frog look high, dude?
It looks like the one from Sonic Adventure. Froggy!
Oh, you know what we gotta play? Sonic Adventure 2 Battle.
Yeah, I have the first one. I wanted to stream it, but I also wanted to playtest it first. So I did like a couple playtests of it.
So, Battle is a DLC for, I think, Sonic Adventure
2. Yeah. That's the...
And it's a multiplayer
one. That's the GameCube one, right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. So, it's a multiplayer DLC who's, mode.
Who's that? Dude, is that Frozone?
Is that the alien from Stitch?
From Monster vs. Aliens?
Is that Omar?
Is that Tomar?
Tomar, yeah.
No, Tomar is not in this game.
What are you talking about? He's bald.
So, every bald man Tomar B?
Yes.
Wait, isn't that what Lyle said?
Maybe.
I remember there was one where they did say that, like, every bald man Tomar B.
I gotta say, they kind of... I'm kind of impressed how they managed to do this remaster.
Oh, like how it actually went through?
Yeah. Considering that this game franchise hasn't had a game since like 2012.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was going to, but then it got canned.
Yeah. You did me give us a Mickey 3.
Well, I think they also like canceled it because of Oswald being a part of Universal, right?
Which doesn't make sense considering he was in the second game.
Hmm.
Unless there was
but
like
that was before, right? Game. That was before.
Yeah. Unless there was, like, some behind-the-scenes shenanigans going on.
Like some Disney scandal?
I don't know. Probably some licensing shit.
Hmm.
I should probably go get my laundry. It is done drying.
Alright, you do that, and I'm gonna look around for secrets.
But I am being distracted by this game.
Just have it in your pocket or something.
Oh no, you attacked the black kid. I didn't know this was a horror movie. Horror game. Oh no, war crimes.
Mickey Mouse is racist.
I mean... Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, just look at that face. I wouldn't trust him.
Look at that. Look at that. He looks like a...
He looks like he owns slaves.
I love that joke. From freaking John Tryon.
Oh god. Day. No.
Oh no.
What if
every
time Mickey fell, he said, "Oh no!" like Knuckles.
Oh no! You know, it'd be real easy if you like erase that shit.
No, you're supposed to. I'm supposed to do it like that, right? Or am I?
I don't know, maybe try.
Okay, let me try this. Let me try stopping it until it reaches flat. Maybe that's what I'm supposed to do.
There you go. Big brain. Yo, remember when Disney thought it was a good idea to make a skateboard game?
Oh, you mean the GameCube one? The one that looked
and
like... And it looked like ass?
Failed. What happens if you press button?
What does this button do, Dexter?
Don't worry, Professor. I was a mistake too.
That is not Dexter.
I know, but I just wanted to quote that scene.
Yeah, did you actually watch my live stream I did at the Dexter's Lab game?
No.
Yeah, it was so funny. Like half the time, it was just me getting like confused of what was the going on with the like how like the game kept switching gameplay. But then again, as to be expected, because I later found out it was just like a mini game collection.
Ah, cool. Those are always fun. Sometimes. Oh no! No, not again! Mickey, stop! Stop, Mickey!
He's doing this for Song of the South.
Yeah, he's angry that shit never got re-released. Honestly, it's kind of upsetting that it never got a re-release, except for like one time in home videos.
Oh god!
Oh no! Oh no, not your souls.
My souls.
Oh wait, wrong franchise. Stop it, Mickey. Mickey, no! Think of the children.
Fuck the children. I just care about the parents'
children?
Money.
You're barely even human.
No, what's that thing from SpongeBob where it's like, I don't care about the children. I don't care about the children. I just care about the parents' money.
And then all you see is Mickey singing Savages from Pocahontas.
Kill them!
They're barely even human.
That's racist. So what are... So yeah, I know, but like, what... Is he trying to imply that they're aliens?
As much as I like making fun of Mickey Mouse, because let's be real, the character was made in what, the 30s,
oh god,
40s?
Earlier. He was like...
Yeah, more or less.
He was like the 20s, right? Oh!
Maybe. But let's be real, Walt wasn't the best. But also wasn't the worst. I'm not sure. Dude. Basically, he was a human.
He was an alien. Ooh. He was an animorph. He was
He was a transformer.
Transformer.
Optimus Walt.
Hippo.
Transformers, races in disguise. Hey, that's not how this.
Oh, it's
goes.
Giraffe. It's gonna come down. Oh, it's gonna come down. It's gonna say Simba.
Run and never return.
If you say so.
Oh boy. Of course. I'll do it again.
Fragile, destroy Murder. 100 destructible. I love how I got an achievement for killing those guys.
What's it called?
It's just called Fragile, break 100 objects.
Oh, I thought it was gonna be some like...
Like, racist?
Joke. Joke.
Hey, look at this guy.
Like, an achievement called like hatred. An achievement called hate crime.
Look at this guy, he's flying with his feet.
I don't know.
Bum, bum, bum. Bum, bum, bum.
We're Canadians after all.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Oh!
Remember, folks, it's not a crime until you do it first. It's the pastime of any Canadian.
Oh, no!
That's a joke, folks. Don't do crimes.
Oh, I thought that guy's name was Pizza.
Don't do any crimes. Oh no, you can't even jump. You suck.
Hey, he's not Edmund.
If you guys don't know who Edmund is,
yeah, it's pretty much
our server.
Alright, so me and David, we have an inside joke.
Dude.
No. Can I just explain briefly what it is?
Edmund sucks, you don't have to talk.
No, I just wanna explain it just in case
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright, so inside our server, we were watching the Chronicles of Narnia, the first one I believe it was, right?
Yeah, it was the first one.
The lion, the wardrobe, whatever. And pretty much, and like, half the time we were just making fun of the Edmund kid because he kept making stupid decisions.
It's the lion, the predator, and
the predator
child. Yeah, the witch.
Dude, I still love that one frame that we took where, like, he's like, he has, like, his back arched with the swords.
Yeah.
When he's, like, dodging the swords and he's, like, making that moan face.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I just busted a fat nut.
Chronicles of Narnia. Chris Hansen, the Predator, and the Child.
Chris Hansen.
If you watch the first movie, then you know why I'm calling it that. Because of the White Witch and the weird thing she has for Edmund?
Oh, you mean like when she's like, when he betrays his family for Turkish delight?
Yeah, freaking weirdo.
It's like, what are you craving? Turkish delight?
I don't even know if Turkish delight was worth it, dude.
Yeah, did you ever watch that one video where the person was actually making Turkish delight and they're like, it's like in this video we'll be making Turkish delight and to see if it's actually worth betraying your family for.
What?
It was just teaching people how to make Turkish delight.
The fact that Santa Claus exists in the universe of Narnia is just hilarious. It doesn't say it's Santa Claus, but come on, let's be real, it's probably it.
We dig, 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 how's that song go?
Diggity dig.
No, from Snow White, where it's like, we dig, dig, dig. The hi-ho, hi-ho.
Off the home we go. I don't want to get a lawsuit.
Oh, side-scroller.
Yeah, Metal Gear.
Oh, no.
How?
Da-na-na-na.
Dude, no, Nintendo's gonna sue you now. Oh, shit.
I'm surprised that this hasn't gotten sued in the long run.
What?
This, where he's opening a chest.
Well, you know, it's a game mechanics. You can't really sue people for game mechanics. Unless you're WB and decide to freaking trademark the Nemesis system.
Is that real?
Yeah. It's a real shame, too. That system is so cool, and it could have been used for so many cool games. Do you ever get the chance to play into the Middle Earth duology, I think? I don't even know if they're working on a third game. Check them out. Shadow and War. Shadow, no, as Shadow of Mordor.
Oh, I know that guy. Wolf. Is that the Beagle Boy?
No, is that's Pete.
Pete, yeah. It also reminds me of the Beagle Boys from DuckTales.
Yeah, Shadow War and Shadow of Mordor.
Oh, this is the guy from the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse show, right?
No, it's Peach. He's
an asshole.
He's looking for the...
No, it's...
He's looking for the kingdom.
He's a big chungus.
Yeah. Big chunker.
Big chunker.
Big chunky.
Big and Chunky from Madagascar?
Dude, doesn't he have to help Sora fight, like...
Why is he wearing a wig?
Because he's beautiful, okay? Leave him be.
He's wearing drag. He's a pirate lady?
Don't question him, dude. He's pure.
Now we're in... China!
Japan?
This looks like the Jade Palace.
Somewhere in Asia?
It's the Valley of Peace.
Hey, Oswald, what's up, dog?
What if there was a taunt where he's giving the middle finger?
Probably is.
Like a mod?
This game came out, like, what, a few days ago, so I doubt
A few
it.
Days ago? This came out in September.
Was it September?
Oh, God. Yeah, it came out, like, near the end.
Dude, you know what game we should play on Halloween?
What?
It's a co-op game, and it's on Steam. We should play Resident Evil 5.
Maybe. I still don't know if I'm going to be able to... I'll have to see about that, because I still want to see if I can make it to my trip to Boston.
Oh shit, you going to Boston?
Yeah, I wanted to go to that Rhode Island convention.
What's going on in Rhode Island?
Just a Comic-Con. That, my friend... Just a... Comic-Con that my friend Checkers is going to.
Yo, what's up, Checkers? How you doing? I don't know if they're watching this, so I'm just saying what's up.
He'll probably watch the playback of this, but he's probably busy working on one of his new videos. Because he's working on a Courage video, as he was explaining in his server today.
Dude, if you ever need me to edit any like audio, hit me up.
You can just edit my streams.
Oh no.
Just turn it into a funny montage of us just saying random shit.
Called the Wild Streams.
It can just be J out of context.
Context without con.
I don't know. It would just be funny to hear me say, like, hearing myself talk about random things or saying oddly.
And on the videos that we're in, I'm just gonna edit my voice out.
How the hell are you gonna do that if, like.
Make you sound crazy.
Make me. If anything, I could just, like, fuck this up and, like. Pretend like I didn't hit start the whole time.
Because you could technically do that. You
could or edit. I can just mute the desktop audio.
Yeah.
So I can't hear you anymore.
So Jay and me, I'm gonna tell a little story now. Story time with me. It's your boy,
David.
Spidey.
Be careful on what you're gonna say.
So this was in 2016, 17?
Mm-hmm.
This was when I was still streaming.
Oh, I know where this is going.
Yeah.
I know exactly where this is going.
So, we decided, hey, you know what would be cool if we read...
Fanfic. Pokemon.
Was it Pokemon?
Yeah, it was. It was like Pearl. Yeah, it was like Pearl shipping.
It wasn't even shipping, dude.
Yeah, it was. Wasn't it like Ash and Dawn or something like that?
I think it was Ash and Serana.
Ash and Serena? No, I think it was the Diamond and Pearl one.
I don't know. Anyways, we were reading the fan fiction. We kind of stopped in chapter 1 or 2. I don't quite remember quite well. Yeah, it was just the weirdest thing. I don't know why I decided to drag Jay into it.
I think I just...
I have no idea.
I think what happened was is that we were just having a discussion, and then, like, in mid-discussion, we just, like, stumbled upon that, and you were like, hey, you want to read this? And I was like, eh, why not?
I don't even think it was a live stream.
No, I think it was... No, it was, because I remember... No, it was either a live stream or a video you just posted. Play Gremlin Herman 100 e-tickets stopped by the Whirlpool. What?
As of, I think, last month, I kind of privatized all my videos.
Oh, was this what you were talking about? Like, the yes and no mechanic thing?
Yeah. The voice mechanic.
Alright,
so
go on.
So, depending on your answer, you have different quests and boss fights.
Alright, go on about the video.
So, yeah, I kind of made all my videos private, and I ran into an old... I don't think it was a fanfic one, but it was, like, when I played Clock Tower, the original game.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I said the original game. There hasn't been a remake or remaster for that game, so... But technically, there is a Japan and US version, so... Who knows? Yeah, I just felt like privatizing all the videos that was the best for now. So I haven't uploaded. Like,
oh, he can wall climb? I didn't know that.
Since 2017. Plus, I'm also thinking of rebranding and creating a new channel. And just start uploading history videos. Content team.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a weird word I see. Content stuff. Content. Jesus. I speak no English good anymore. My brain goes into lizard mode.
Wizard mode?
Lizard mode.
Lizard mode?
Caveman too. Yeah, so while I did that, I kind of remembered all the dream thing.
Mm-hmm.
Or, fanfic we did. Actually, I think I remember it just now, so I might be mixing it too. It's a long day. It's like almost midnight here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the fanfiction wasn't horrible from what I remember. Then again, I don't think we ever finished it, so it might have not even been that good.
It's not that good, therefore we didn't finish it. That sounds very logical.
Or maybe it was just way too awkward to read?
Oh yeah, like, I do remember we were just, like, laughing too much, and we were just like, alright, that's enough, and we were just, like, laughing too hard, and we just stopped recording.
I was like, oh, I'm done with this shit. I'm out here 500.
It's over 9,000!
My clothes is still in the dryer.
Hmm.
Oh, fuck. I hadn't gotten up classes this week, so I could wait until later.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's reading week. Midterms is next week, so there's a few studying to do. I think I'm just gonna wait until Friday and just cramp it all in one day.
Yeah, you're just like me if I was in college, just like have the week to myself, and just like the last minute I'm just like, okay, I gotta get this done.
Cause I tend to forget things quite a bit. Mm-hmm. So cramping it into one day actually kind of helps me.
Yeah, cause you're more focused on it.
And this is like 10 PowerPoints I gotta go and revisit. But like, two of the classes, the assignments are fairly similar that I could just reuse the... I could just reuse the script or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Or just tweak it. It's easy. One, I gotta record a story. Like, write a 59 seconds audio story.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I gotta write the script and all that. Script? Oh, script. There we go, I said the word right. It's English, good now.
Dude, look, it's a dragon.
It's a dragon. Is it gonna grant us wish? Is it seven wishes or one wish?
You collect the seven dragon balls and you get one wish. Or I think, I don't know, I'm not a dragon ball person.
Yeah, I'm not either, but I saw this clip of, I think it was Bulma. Or like Chi-Chi or something, some shit like that.
Oh, are you talking about my buns could use a lift?
Yeah. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
I only know that because my sister told me about it.
I ran into it, I'm like, what the shit is this?
And you know what makes it even funnier?
What?
The fact that it's official and not like an R34.
Oh, it's official? I thought it was like a parody or something.
No, it's real.
What the fuck is going on over in Dragon Ball?
Hentai.
Probably. Most likely, yes. 100%, yeah. I've seen it.
Did you ever see that one that people are simping for? It's pretty much just like Bulma in like a Playboy bunny outfit.
You mean the official bit that happened?
Is that Steamboat Willie?
Oh, it's public domain. Yeah, let's
It is!
Go. Let's go, it's public domain, baby!
And we can't get sued for it.
Fuck you, Disney. You know, Song of the South enters public domain next year.
Oh, this is cool.
It's either next year or 2 years.
Wait. Get up.
Yes.
Minky, you can't jump high.
Song of the
Wait, what? Oh, there we go.
Did you just get a...
It's because there's like a little bird in there. This is cool.
Oh, Song of South enters public domain in 2041. Although, technically, I think in Canada, it's already in public domain pretty soon.
Yeah, Canada is less protective.
Yeah.
Because I was talking about this to a friend, because, like, they were talking about ideas to do for a stream, and I was like, and I mentioned how, like, an interesting topic I like to go into is, like, underrated shows that people grew up with that not that many people talk about. And I brought up, and they were someone was bringing up, like, Canadian cartoons, and I was talking about, like, how some of them do have copyright standards, and some of them, a majority of them don't, but I'm talking about, like, ones that, like, are more popular, like Totally Spies has a copyright, what else has a copyright? Yeah. Like, pretty much anything that's, like, I think Total Drama also does, too.
Yeah, as I was saying, because we still go under the original copyright laws that
but
were established.
What I'm saying
ago.
Is that, like, there are some cartoons that, like, we've watched on stream that haven't gotten banned yet, and I was bringing that up as an example if they were to either watch or just talk about them.
Yeah. I think 16 is pretty good at that. There's a few others. Here's the thing, you could technically crank out this beat, this song playing right now. It won't give you a copyright strike.
Yep.
I think, I don't know.
I mean, it's like a different version of the song, like it's like a game version of it, so I don't think so.
Oh man, you gotta play Kingdom Hearts, they have this level there in one of the games. It's when they go like time travel or some shit, I don't remember. You fight Peach. And then Peach fights evil Peach from the future. Kingdom Hearts is a weird franchise, but I love the shit out of it. No, don't leave the world. Oh, back to the boring, mundane, modern life.
Goose modern life.
Yeah, I think America's might be wrong on this, but I think America's literally the only one that has like the longest copyright.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's mainly because of Disney, because they're like every time Mickey was about to enter public domain. They would try to extend the years, which worked like once or twice, maybe three times, I'm not sure. But that's why we have such a, not we, but you know, the US has like such a long time for public domain. Not just Disney shit, but like in general. I fully believe if it wasn't for Disney, we would have had almost everything from the 60s and 70s already in the public. And I could be doing the math completely wrong here and talking out of my ass. But like, let's be real.
Dude, look, it's Mrs. Potts!
Oh, that's sick, dude.
See that?
Ashley, can we put this in a top 10 places that look cozy?
Top 10 places that look cozy?
Because, man, I would totally sleep on there.
It kind of reminds me of the, like, the, what is it? Like, the design layout for, like, Inside Out, where, like, the emotions sleep. They sleep in, like, those little beds.
Is that Mrs. Pot? Look at that. Would you not want to sleep in here?
That's a green Mrs. Pot. This looks like Amelia Earhart's facility.
Oh, isn't that the movie where she bangs Ben Stiller?
Yeah. And then Owen Wilson comes out and he says, I don't know about you guys, but he just reached second base.
No, he comes out and says, like, wow.
Oh, dude, did I tell you that I didn't know that a majority of the licensed Disney games are on Steam?
Yeah, most of them are.
It's so almost like I didn't know that, like, a majority of the Sonic games are on Steam.
Mm-hmm. I remember back in the day when Disney website used to, like, upload games.
Oh, yeah, like the Phineas and Ferb, like the Snowball one and stuff like that.
Yeah, they, and sometimes they have, like,
the Zack and Cody one.
Like their...
Oh, yeah, I remember Austin I played
Wonderland.
This was before Disney bought this company, but I remember I played a demo of Ice Age 3.
Mm.
And it was kind of like a platformer with Scrat still.
Yeah. Yeah, they used to have demos on their old website when they uploaded games.
Mm-hmm.
Which was kind of cool because
Oh, look at this place. This dude is definitely a gamer. Look
Which
at all these...
Kinda cool because
dude,
I,
look at all
I
these
watched.
Computers this guy has.
What a gamer.
What a gamer.
Oh no, we can't say that. That's a slur word.
Dude, look, he has a... He has a TV within TVs.
Gamer's a swear word now.
Dude, look, he has a...
It's been
TV
tainted
here
over
and he has...
the years. Yeah, I played the original Alice in Wonderland game there.
Mm-hmm.
When the live-action movie came out, they made a Wii game.
Oh yeah, the Tim Burton one, right?
Yeah. That also came out on the PC and other consoles, I think. And I played the demo, and it was, like, pretty interesting. Kind of was like the movie, but not really. Been years. They also had a DS version which looked completely different.
Yeah, I think like most DS... Dude, do you remember at that one point in time, like, when they would advertise like the console versions but they would never ever show like how the handheld ones look for like Game Boy Advance and DS?
And then it just has like a different story or like gameplay design.
Yeah, it's more like 2D platformer. Or like semi 3D.
Like better than the actual main game, which is just funny to me.
Yeah, I remember there was a guy talking about that over the SpongeBob games.
I could be wrong on the Alice Wonderland one.
What, the demo?
No, the DS part. Like, it could have been like the original one and not be like totally different. Again, it's been years.
It's fine.
And I really don't want to... I really don't want to buy Alice in Wonderland.
You don't want to...
Because it's like...
You don't want to say a bunch of shit you don't believe.
No, it's just... Because... PC Disney games, I think they tend to have, like, bad ports. I could be wrong on that, but I've seen, I think it was you or another friend play freaking GeForce.
GeForce?
Yeah, the hamsters.
I don't think I've never watched GeForce, if I'm being honest. Maybe it's someone else.
Oh, please do, watch it. It's pretty good. Except we're kind of not really... It's alright. It's not my favorite Disney movie, but it's also not my least favorite.
Oh, you know what this reminds me of?
Castlevania?
This reminds me of that new Disney game that came out for the Switch, the Illusion Island, whatever it's called.
Give me a second. What the shit was that noise?
It was a stork. Or a pelican. Wait, Castlevania has a thing like this? Oh, this is pretty cool.
Back to talking shit about PC.
Huh?
I'm back talking shit about Disney, let's go. You know what? I think I mentioned this before to you, but like, I should probably finish the conversation. I'm sorry to people. I saw one of you guys, Jay or another friend, play GeForce, and I was like, you know what?
I don't think it was me, because I would have remembered me playing GeForce.
Yeah, it might have been someone else. But yeah, it's a stealth game.
Maybe it was Joseph.
Maybe. The game runs kind of good, but it does have issues sometimes. I think this is just a thing in older games in general, because newer hardware is weird.
Mm-hmm.
This is why I always check the PC. Is it PC Gaming Wiki? Yeah, the PC Gaming Wiki, if I ever run into any issue, they tend to have fixes. I haven't checked every page because that would be insane. I only check the games that I play. Is not insane. So far they've helped a great deal. Sometimes you could find fixes on like old game packs,
mm-hmm.
Forms.
So what do you think of the game so far, David?
This game is great. You could also find fixes on what do you call them? On like Steam forums and like Reddit. I know it's a weird place to find it.
What, Epic
and
Mickey?
Rarely... No, game fixes.
Hey, look, we're back to here, so you don't have to complain anymore. Shut up.
Yeah. Fuck you, Mickey. I'm kidding.
I was just gonna say, don't be mean.
Mickey's pretty cool. Well, no, Mickey's not cool. Mickey is a villain in Kingdom Hearts.
Mickey is a villain. He's the villain of corporate society.
Yeah, exactly.
No wonder I switched to DreamWorks.
Honestly, yes.
I honestly think DreamWorks is probably making the best movies nowadays.
Yeah, DreamWorks and Illumination, surprisingly.
Like, people like to talk shit about Kung Fu Panda 4. I didn't think it was all that bad.
No, it was fine. I could do without Aquafina, but...
The Wild Robot was amazing. Dude, you know it's another movie that like I didn't expect that I would like, but I actually ended up liking it.
What is it?
Boss Baby 2.
Okay, so
that movie is actually like really wholesome.
This is about Kung Fu Panda. I saw this video talking about, like, all the Kung Fu Panda shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the lore and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
And the person mentioned the movie should have been a buddy cop movie with, Tai Long and Ho.
Oh, you mean, like, when they're going through the different pitches for Kung Fu Panda 4? And, like, it was supposed to originally end with, like, Tai Long being the next Dragon Warrior?
Basically, it should have been Tai Long and Po going against the Chameleon. this dude is just talking about, like, what he wanted the story be mm-hmm. about or something like that.
Oh, what he wanted is... I thought it was, like, the where they're going through the different pitches for the fourth movie.
But yeah, Tai Long and Po should have teamed up, and then Tai Long slowly realized...
Dude, look!
Yo,
Mickey's killed the British.
This dude Po is pretty dope.
Dude, did you see that? Mickey just killed the British.
No, don't worry. He's
look.
British. This is how Britain looks like.
Well, what do you expect? Disney never gets culture shit right.
Dude, where's the British 12-year-olds with knives?
Dude, they're right there. What do you mean?
Where's the birds with knives?
The birds with knives?
I'm kidding. I haven't been in Britain yet.
You haven't been in Britain?
Oh, I haven't been in Britain yet, mate. There you go. Well, I'm showing you that.
It's like the only Britain, you know. Wait, is he even British?
Johnny Depp?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Jonathan Depp. Jonathan? Oh no, he's flooding Britain.
What if they put Tai Lung into DreamWorks Racing?
Is his ability is to, like, jump on people?
Dude, you remember that one Tai Lung edit where, like, they put, like, the cat meowing? And you just kept laughing at it for, like, 5 minutes?
It was funny, dude. Meow.
Yeah, he's like, meh.
Why is Mickey killing monkeys?
No, they're Britons. They're the British children.
Oh no, they just want food, mate.
Dude, all they need is just like a big ass swirly lollipop.
The lollipop, yo, the lollipop.
No, yeah. do you ever see like those children that have like the overalls, the red and white striped shirt, and they have like a propeller hat and a big ass swirly lollipop?
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're the Eiffel Tower, apparently.
Jeez, can you stop your, like, terrorism, Mickey?
Mickey's a terrorist. Dude, he's gonna... No, you know what I think is gonna happen? We're gonna have an ability that turns Mickey really big and he's gonna climb just like King Kong.
First you go to Britain, you kill children, and then you go to...
Become King Kong?
France.
I see London, I see France.
I see a bunch of dead children.
That doesn't even rhyme. What the heck? Oh god.
It doesn't have to rhyme when it comes to murder.
It doesn't need to rhyme when it comes to murder. David, 2024.
Because Mickey is a terrorist. Yeah, I'm so gonna edit this down. All this out. Seriously, folks, don't commit crimes.
And don't kill children.
Yes. That is a moral story.
Don't kill children.
See, this is also an educational channel.
And it just plays like the French music.
What French music?
The one that the accordion was like do 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 do. Like, you know that like Google Translate meme where like it's like Darth Vader. Darth Vader.
Oh, that one.
Yeah. And
it's... You know what's my favorite? Have you seen that meme?
No.
It's like, I think it's like, what's the name of the meme? French is a weird language or something like that. And it's literally just the sentence, like, my uncle is something. But the French words all start the same.
Uh-oh.
French is a weird language.
Oh, I was supposed to do that.
Canadian who does not know French completely.
Karma, Canadian.
I only know one sentence and like one other sentence.
Karma, Canadian. Oh, this is where I came from.
Here in Canada, we don't really... We are taught French, but... let's be real, most of us don't speak it.
Yeah. Or at least in the Toronto area.
Yeah.
I think more French is like... I heard French is more like Ottawa, Montreal sort of deal. Yeah,
Montreal, Quebec.
Quebec, yeah.
We Torontonians would be like brother.
We're just pretty not much, brother. It's just pretty much New York.
Yeah, we go like, how's it going, brother?
We don't take kindly to your parts.
We go like, fam, it be like that.
We don't like farmers?
No, fam.
Farm?
Not farm.
Fam? Oh, like Ernie and Bernie?
You know that Toronto Canadian memes? Where like these two dudes are talking and they're like all like... It's pretty funny, you showed me once.
Oh, light-skinned Monty?
Yeah.
The guy who's like, oh shit, a rat! Is that the guy?
Tony is speak like.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh no, that's Toronto guy Cody.
Yeah. That's how most of us, I like to think we speak, but we hear ourselves normally and no one else hears it the same. Mm-hmm. Then again, I'm pretty sure that's how accents work, you know? You don't hear the accent of yourself, but other people do.
Yeah.
It's a weird thing. It's a funny thing. Although, at the same time, you do hear it.
It's like very rare, though.
I could say something in Spanish right now to you, and you probably understand because. Let's just say most of our neighborhood and our old high school was a lot of like Portuguese, Spanish folks.
Mhm. And like some black.
Oh yeah, that's Toronto, dude. I'm kidding. Toronto is a. It's a multicultural.
It's a multicultural. I was gonna say, there's no discrimination.
Actually, I think most of Canada is. It's just some parts are more than others. I guess. I don't know. So that's pretty, that's a given, dude. Mm-hmm. The multicultural thing.
Yeah, Am I even going the right way?
I don't know, brother. You tell me. Do you know the way?
Do I know the way?
Turn out. It's not the only place in Canada, so can you... Oh, you guys are gonna hate me with this, but... Can you Americans stop showing Toronto as the one location in Canada? I know it's gotta be Americans mostly doing this.
What, they're just trolling?
No, where they're like mostly showing Toronto instead of other areas in Canada.
Oh, like Hamilton, where you live?
Well, you know, Hamilton is mostly filmed. Most movies are filmed here. But like Canada in general, I think they're pretty cheap. Filming. I might be wrong, it might just be Toronto. Deep to film. But yeah, there's lovely other locations in Toronto. Jesus Christ.
Like, yeah, like Niagara.
Yeah, Niagara. You could go to British Columbia. That's... Or Alberta if you want to film a freaking Western.
Feel Western.
For you folks that don't know, Alberta is essentially the Texas of Canada, in only the sense that it's pretty much just cowboys and none of the, how may I put this? Basically none of the offensive stuff, I guess. Not saying there isn't, but I'm also not saying there is. Let's be real, not everybody's gonna be like, hey, you're pretty cool. Platforming you're doing here, and somehow you're not pulling it off.
Yeah, I don't understand the pattern here.
Maybe try to.
Oh, there I go.
Or do that. I just remember something. If we do play Kingdom Hearts, there's a boss fight against Captain Hook's Shadow. Not Captain Hook, Storm Shadow. And it's like pretty freaking hard. I would say it's like the second or third hardest boss fight ever.
Hmm. I'll try to remember that.
Which. It's a good fight. Anyways, other places that people could film in would be pretty cool. None of it.
Dude, do you remember, like, when you were in school, and, like, when they played the O Canada, they did it, like, in, like, both versions, like, in English, and, like, halfway it would switch to French?
No one would sing in a crash, at least from what I remember.
Hey, look, it's your favorite character.
It's Tomar.
No, that's not Tomar.
Yeah, anyways,
Oh, is this a boss? Alright, if this is a boss, Nineveh, I'm gonna turn it off after.
It might be a boss. Nineveh is a pretty cool place to film. even though there's barely anything there, but it's still a cool place. There's that, was it EI, Prince Edward?
Yeah.
That's also a pretty cool place.
Prince Edward Island?
Yeah. Basically, Toronto's not the only place to film movies, so... I feel like when people talk of Canada, it's always about Toronto.
Or at least for the most part.
Yeah. Which is ironic considering that we're talking about it.
Yep.
Whatever. Yeah, if you guys visit Canada, check out all of our...
Check out all of our landscapes.
Other places. Not just New York. Yeah. I don't know why I said New York, but it's the closest comparison I can think of. Well, technically it would be Chicago. I think is in New York?
Chicago's in New York? No, it's not. Chicago's its own place, right?
Is it?
I believe so. Holy shit, we've been live for almost 2 hours now.
Chicago, leaving November
9th. No, that's not what I want.
Are you talking to Siri?
Yeah. I kind of forgot how to write it.
Whoa, is that a panther? Go into his mouth, Mickey. Wait, can I even go up there? Or maybe that's where I'm supposed to go.
Yeah, it's, Chicago is in Illinois.
It's in LNA?
It's besides, it's on Lake Michigan. I swear, I keep forgetting. Everyone forgets.
Oh, dude,
about, like,
this is such a cool shot. I'm gonna make this the thumbnail. Look at this.
Kind of. You know what it looks like?
The Cave of Wonders?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is why we're friends.
I remember there. I think I made that same joke when I was playing Ori in the Will of the Wisp.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do his voice?
What?
The Cave of Wonders?
No, dude.
You can do the voice, can't you?
How does he sound like it? I don't know if it's a she or he.
It's like, Hooters, enter the cave.
Cave of Wonder. I put Wonder of Cave.
Wonder of Cave.
The cave.
Oh god, that looks like a Tim Burton thing. Isn't it? Alright. Go back into the Mario 64.
What looks like a Tim Burton thing?
That moon that was there.
I'm watching a clip right now.
Of?
Alright, okay. I can't have my voice. This isn't doing that anymore.
Who goes there?
It is I, the Gazim.
Isn't he like a throw cutter?
Huh?
Didn't Gazim like slit throats?
I think so.
I think that's implied in the show or like the movie.
Giving you your reward. Your eternal reward.
You haven't seen the show?
The Aladdin show?
Check it out. Did it ever release?
It did.
Yeah, it did. I don't know if there's that on Disney Plus because I haven't checked. I only see the movies. Seen the movies. I like the King of Thieves.
Mm-hmm.
Probably my favorite Aladdin movie out of the. Three? Yeah, three. Return of Jafar is pretty good too. It's actually pretty cool. So I might have to rank that higher. There was a cut. Hey, look at that cloud. It looks like Mickey.
Oh yeah, it does.
There was a few cut songs from those movies.
Which one, Aladdin, or?
Yeah, just in all three of them, there was a good chunk of cut music.
Yeah, there was supposed to be a reprise of Arabian Nights where, like, it revealed that the merchant was actually the genie.
Yeah, there was a song for Jafar. Jafar was supposed to have a song in the original movie.
I don't remember if they brought that back in the remake, did they?
I don't think so. But again, I didn't watch it fully.
Alright, I think that's it.
But, yeah, I don't know why Disney sequels get so much crap.
Bad rep?
Bad rep, yeah. They're actually decent films.
Yeah, I like some of them.
Some of them are even better than the original. I said it.
Yeah. Like, what was it? I think my sister said that about the, what was it, like the 101 Dalmatian sequel?
Yeah, those are good. I think the only one that I really don't like is Mulan 2.
No, can we acknowledge Pocahontas 2?
Pocahontas
and that
is
that one part where it's like John Smith.
I'm the ghost of John Smith.
I am the ghost of John Smith. Dude, that is so meme-y on so many levels. Oh, boss.
Mulan 2, it's not the worst movie, but because I do have my favorite parts in it. There's a few parts that I like.
Mm-hmm.
Like the whole like thing with the three princesses or whatever they are trying to date or whatever. I don't quite remember it, but I remember it was Ping Ming. Cow. The three military dudes.
Yeah.
The military bros.
they fall in love with the three princesses, and that whole plot line I like. Like, the rest of the movie is...
Wait.
Check it out if you guys are curious.
I don't get what I'm supposed to do here.
Use your abilities. I don't know.
That's what I'm trying to do.
But, yeah, just check it out. You know. Make your own thoughts about it. Fox and a Hound 2 is pretty good. The Cinderella trilogy
is
great.
You know what I saw people actually really like?
Mm.
Tarzan.
Tarzan 2?
Yeah.
That one's good too. Yeah, that one was... I think it was a pilot for a show.
No, that was Tarzan and Jane.
Yeah. Most of the Disney sequels are either pilots for shows or their own thing.
Can I be honest?
Yeah.
I didn't know that the Lilo and Stitch ones were supposed to be a show.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. I do like the Lilo and Stitch movies.
Mm-hmm.
I like the show more. Just because of how many, like, cool aliens they have.
Yeah, it's pretty much just Pokemon for Disney.
It's just...
Oh, there I go!
Really, if you want to make a better comparison, it's Pokemon and Men in Black. Yeah.
Okay, I think I get what I'm supposed to be doing here.
Yeah, check out the Cinderella trilogy. They're great movies. Anastasia is probably the one with most character development out of the villains.
Yeah, I did hear about that. You and my sister really likes that one.
Yeah. Cinderella 3 is where they decided to introduce time travel for some reason, but it works really well. So, I'm just gonna spoil, like, the first scene. Essentially, the evil stepmother gets the wand from
Hey,
the
dude, doesn't this kind of look like a machine from 9?
I know, yeah. Yeah, the stepmother gets the wand from the fairy godmother and time travels.
Is that what happens?
Yeah. Lion King trilogy is also a good movie, good series.
Mm-hmm.
I like Lion King 2 more than the first one.
I also like 1.5 too. I will say I do also like the... People like to complain about the animation in Lion King 2, but I think it looks pretty good for what it worked with.
Yeah, 1.5 and freaking Simba's Bride.
I think 1.5. I think 1.5 kind of has the same art style as the first.
Yeah.
Or at least for some
parts.
1.5
had a higher budget than the Simba's Bride, but they still look good.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't that also one of the few Disney sequels that they actually put out in theaters?
Because
I heard that and Jungle Book 2 were in theaters.
Ooh, another good Disney sequel you folks should check out is Rescuers 2.
Small World. Paint or thin the Mad Clock Tower. I got another achievement. That's cool.
Rescuers Down Under. Great movie. It's... equally as good as the first one.
Alright, I think I'm just gonna do this one mini level and then we're gonna call it a night.
Quite rare.
Does that sound good to you?
Yeah. There's a few others that I don't remember or haven't watched yet. I watched most of them. Movies that I wish that had sequels would have to be The Great Mouse Detective, The Black Cauldron, and I want to say Aristocats, but
Goofy!
It's the Goofster.
But wake me up! Sing the Wake Me Up Inside.
Aristocats is one of those movies that really doesn't need a sequel.
Sing the Goofy, Wake Me Up.
Save me from my seal. Oh, can you feel inside your heart? Like open doors, bleeding your dark.
Oh no.
Wake me up inside. Save me from my seal. Cute. Sorry, I had to do fools right now. I can't do a proper impression.
Of who, Goofy?
Nah. Of the Goofers.
Hey, look.
Oh,
it's
is that the mystery?
Illuminati. The mystery shack, yeah. Oh, look at that guy. Oh, you know what that looks like back there? That looks like the tower from Nightmare Before Christmas.
I think they have this level in Kingdom Hearts.
This,
Burst My Sleep 2.
The Mean Street?
Yeah. Or at least they have, like, something very similar to PH Burst My Sleep 0.2.
Alright, you think we should call it here for now?
I don't know, finish the level? I don't know.
No, we already did. This is gonna be a whole nother mission thing.
At least commit war crimes before you go. Hate the town.
Yeah, you know what this kinda looks like also?
What?
This kinda looks like the opening of Mario Galaxy.
Oh yeah, it does a bit.
Where like Mario's like running through the castle and until like it gets like taken over.
Again, folks, don't. To sum up this stream, commit war crimes. Don't do crimes.
I think we're gonna call it here. Let me just make sure I save. Wait, the fuck? There's costumes?
Heck yeah. Let's go.
Oh, and I got an achievement for that. Put on a costume for the first time.
Look at that.
That's cool. So our next gameplay, we're just going to keep this. Is that okay with you?
Now we're playing the real Mickey.
The real Mickey. The game we always wanted. A Steamboat Willie game. And
let's
we can't
be real.
And
Mickey
we can
like those.
And guess what? We can't get sued for it because it's public domain.
Mickey in like the original shorts was just a dickhead. He was mean to everyone. At least from what I remember.
Alright, let me just make sure that it's saved. I think this is the autosave, right? This game has autosave?
Maybe. Again, to sum up the stream, don't commit crime. Be good.
Be good Samaritans.
Yeah. This is an educational channel now.
And don't do drugs.
Exactly. This was our PSA.
Oh, I know. The costume disappears when you come back. That's lame.
Why does Mickey look so like,
loaded,
ready to shoot someone?
Yeah, I was gonna say, he's fucking ready to take some motherfuckers down.
I'll do it again. Borscht.
Alright. At least it autosaves, so. So that's good. Alright, let me just switch back to. Alright, you got anything else you have to say before I turn it off?
Cool game, check it out. It's on Steam and GOG.
It's on Steam and console. We are not sponsored, we're just sharing this information.
Yeah, GOG is also another PC platform that you could get it on. Which, if you get it on that, you could just install the offline installers, which basically means you don't need to be connected to the internet.
Mm-hmm.
And you could. I'm not sure. Yeah. I'm not sure if it is on sale right now. I'll check for you guys.
No, I think it's still market price.
You never know, right? This came out like a month ago. I think I saw it on sale. I might be wrong. This is Epic Mickey, yeah? Rebrushed? Yeah, okay, it's currently not on sale.
You liar!
I swear, maybe it was something else that had a similar name.
Or maybe it was the original.
Yeah, that too. So yeah, it's $60 Canadian. Hmm. Which means is probably like $50 or $40, $40.99 US.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you can just look up the prices on, like, online. But yeah, either way, we're gonna end it here, you guys.
We have
so.
Like a $10-$20 difference from the US, so.
It's mostly 10.
Yeah.
But either way, I'm enjoying it so far. Maybe we'll come back to this next weekend if you guys want.
Mickey will commit more crimes in the future, I guess.
I guess so.
Or paint-based crimes. His heart attack.
Either way, thanks everyone for watching, and hopefully we'll see you again next time if David's available again. If not, I'll just stream it on my own.
Follow Jane, you cowards. I'm sorry.
So like I was saying, if David's not available for our next session, then I'll just stream it on my own and he'll probably just be in the chat or something. But I'll definitely let him know beforehand.
Yeah, that was fun.
All right, so see ya. Have a good night.